The button element detects user input and can trigger an event. User input is usually the pointer hovering over or clicking on the button graphic. To create a pre-made button, use the Create menu to create UI button. Like all UI elements, the button element must be the child of a canvas. If one is not present when creating a pre-made button, a new canvas will be created. For more information on the canvas, please see the information link below. A button element requires an image script and a button script. Premade button elements also include an optional text element attached as a child. This text element is optional and can be removed if the button does not need any additional text. For more information on the image and text items, please see the information link below. Interactable determines whether or not this particular button will accept input. To prevent interaction with this button, set Interactable to false. When Interactable is set to false, the transition state for this button element will be set to the disabled state. By default, the button element will display the normal state of the button. The look of the normal state is automatically set by the image component attached to the button element. Depending upon the transition mode chosen, a button can also display a highlighted, pressed, and disabled state. Transition mode determines whether or not the button element will display any of these additional states, and if so, controls the button's look in each state and the style of the transition between these states. The highlighted state is set when the pointer is hovering over the button element, or the button element is selected using keyboard or controller navigation. The pressed state is when the button is being held down, pressed but not released. The disabled state is set when the button element is not interactable. The look and behavior of these other transition states, if available, are determined by the transition mode. The transition mode can be set with a transition pop-up menu. None will have no additional states and therefore no transitions. The button element will work as expected, but there will be no visual feedback, and the unaltered normal state will be displayed at all times. Color tint is the default transition mode. In this mode, the same graphical element is used for each state. Target graphic is the image component to be tinted. In almost all cases, this will be the image component attached to the button element. The button script will set this reference to the attached image component automatically if the image component is attached to the game object when the button script is added. Normal, highlighted, pressed, and disabled color define the tint color that will be applied to the target graphic when the button is in each of these states. Color multiplier multiplies the tint color for each transition by its value. This allows for colors greater than 1, which is useful for brightening the colors or alpha channel on some graphic elements whose base color is less than white or less than full alpha. Fade duration is the time, in seconds, the transition takes between states. Sprite swap will use different sprite images for each state, and swaps them depending upon the state of the button. In this mode, a new graphical element is required for each state. Target graphic is the image for the normal state. In almost all cases, this will be the image component attached to the button element. The highlighted, pressed, and disabled sprites are references to the sprite images to be displayed for each state. Animation allows for each transition to be fully animated using Unity's animation system. This is the most powerful of transition modes due to the number of properties that can be animated simultaneously. To use the animation transition mode, an animator component needs to be attached to the button element. To add this animator component automatically and generate an animator controller with states already set up, click Auto Generate Animation. The new animator controller will need to be saved. No action needs to be taken with this new animator controller. The transition between states can be customized if desired, but but this is not necessary. For more information on the Animator component and the Animator controller, please see the information link below. It is worth noting that, unlike most Animator controllers, this controller will also store the animations for the button's transitions. With the Animator controller attached, and the button element selected, the animations for each of these button states can be edited by opening the animation window. The animation window can be found under Window, Animation, or by using the shortcut keys of Command 6 on the Mac or Control 6 on Windows. To select the state to be edited, use the Animation Clip pop-up menu to select the desired clip. With these pre-made controllers, there should be a state for Normal, Highlighted, Pressed, and Disabled. In most cases, the Normal state will be left empty, with no animation keyframes created, as the Normal state will be set by the values on the button element itself. On all other states, the most common configuration for each state is a single keyframe at 0 seconds, or the start of the timeline. The transition animation between states will be handled by the Animator controller as it fades between states. For example, the width of the button in the highlighted state could be changed by selecting the state to be edited, in this case highlighted, from the Animation Clip pop-up menu, and with the playhead at 0 seconds, or the start of the timeline. Selecting the Record button, changing the width of the button in the inspector, and exiting record mode. When in play mode, note how the button now grows when highlighted. It is worth noting that any number of properties can have their values set in this one keyframe. For more information on animation, animation clips, and the animation window, please see the information link below. If several buttons share the same behavior, these button elements can share Animator controllers. Make sure all of these buttons have their transition mode set to Animation, and that they all have an Animator component attached. Finally, associate the shared Animator controller with all of the button elements. When in play mode, note how all of the buttons now share the same animated transitions. Navigation describes how the selection of UI elements is handled when using keyboard or controller input. Navigation is shared by many UI elements and will be covered in its own lesson. For most circumstances, navigation can simply be set to automatic. For more information on navigation, please see the information link below. The UI framework contains a powerful event system. A new event system is added to the scene when the canvas is created. When the event system detects a press and a release over the same button element, the event system will process a click, and the onClick event will be called. The button component includes a built-in onClick functions list that contains a list of all the functions that are called when the button is clicked. Additional events can be detected and used by the button element, like when the pointer enters or exits the area over the button element, but this requires an additional component to be attached. For more information on events, the event system, and event triggers, please see the information linked below. All of the functions in the functions list will be called when the button is clicked. To add a new function to the function list, click the plus icon to create a new row in the list. To remove a function from the function list, click on the row containing the function, even if there is only one, and then click the minus icon to remove it. Looking at a row in the function list, the checkbox indicates whether or not this function will be called by the onClick event. The first field is an object field. Associating a game object with the object field will allow the event system to find all the functions on that game object eligible to be called by the onClick event. This can be done by either using the object picker or by dragging the object into the field. The function list shows all of the components on the game object, including both the built-in components and custom scripts. After selecting the desired component, a new list shows the eligible functions on the component. Select the function that will be called by the onClick event. The final field is a parameter field. This field is for passing an argument into the function when it is called, and can be left empty. To be eligible, a function must be public, have the return type of void, and have one or no parameters. If the function has a parameter, it must be a float, int, string, bool, or Unity object. It is worth noting that Unity object is the base of almost all classes in Unity, including game object, component, mono behavior, and more. This makes the object parameter more powerful than expected at first glance, as it can accept many items as an argument. If the parameter is a float, int, or string, the value needs to be entered in the parameter field. If the parameter is an object needs to be associated with the parameter field. This can be done by either using the object picker or by dragging the object into the field. If the parameter is a bool, a checkbox will appear and the bool parameter can be set by checking or unchecking the box. As an example, we could add the sphere as the game object to the first row, select the mesh renderer, and then set the mesh renderer's material. The parameter needs an object reference. We can choose any available material. At the same time, the onClick event could call a second function, this time on the capsule. Using the game object itself, the onClick event could call setActive, with the value of false. The most common function to call will most likely be a custom one. Custom functions need to be public, void, and have one or no parameters. If the function has a parameter, it must be a float, int, string, bool, or Unity object. The script must be attached to a game object, and that game object must be associated with the object field. The custom script will be visible in the list, and from the custom script, the custom function can be selected. If there are no parameters, the parameter field can be left blank. Now, in play mode, the effect of all three functions can be seen when the button is clicked.